good morning, good evening, good night, whatever time it is for you when you're watching this. GD here, and I am, as you can see, on my way to start delivering some fuel in my tanker truck. Now, I have been having shit tons of problems this morning. It all started already yesterday when the truck I was driving yesterday, and I was supposed to be driving today, but yesterday it was frozen so much, so I couldn't deliver the fuel from the truck itself. From the trailer I could deliver the fuel, but I couldn't deliver it as normal from the truck itself. Oh, from the truck. But here's the funny part, or however you like to see it. Today, this morning, I came to the office, started up the truck, saw that my delivery was a little bit odd. I called dispatch, and she was like, "Oh, okay, we fixed that, no problem." She did fix my order, so it was correct. And I got to the depot with the truck and was trying to start filling up. And I knew that the truck would be a problem because it would have been freezing. But I didn't thought it would be this much problem. I couldn't even fill it up. It was so frozen that the system over at the depot, the safety system, said, "Nope, you're not connected. You're not connected in the proper way. No, no, no." So I couldn't fill up the truck. I could fill up the trailer, but I couldn't fill up whatever I needed to have on the truck. After a couple of tries and whatnot, I finally started to see some light in the distance, and nope, still didn't want to fill up the truck. So I called the dispatch, I disconnected everything, and I called dispatch. I said, "Hey, can you move the order to the other truck? I can't fill it up, it's frozen. The system is frozen on the truck, so I can't do nothing. It is impossible. I need to call somebody to fix this later today." She's like, "Oh, no problem. I'm on my way to the office, so just hang on and I will send over the order to the other truck." I came back to the office, took all my stuff from the other truck to this truck, and I started up the system here in the truck, saw that the order is already here, took it, went over to the depot once again, and finally everything worked smoothly. Till I noticed one thing. The hardware, the air pressure system on the truck and on the trailer, is nothing wrong with that. But here's the funny part. I have loaded 13,000 liters of diesel on the trailer itself, and rest of the gasoline I also have on the trailer. But on the truck, I only have diesel. On the truck, it was no problem. I could see that the computer was a little bit slow. It didn't catch up on the volumes I have on the tanks on the truck. So I was like, it will be fine. Just have to wait and see. And all of a sudden I when I was about to disconnect everything from the trailer, I noticed that my 13,000 liters of diesel on the trailer was missing on the computer screen outside on the trailer itself. And I was like, hey, wait, where's my 13,000 liters of diesel? It's supposed to be right there. Nope, nothing. I went into the computer here in the truck. Nope, nothing. I have nothing in the trailer apparently. For some reason, the sensors that are supposed to measure how much fuel and whatnot I have in the tanks doesn't work in the last tank part of the tank on the trailer, so I don't see how much diesel I have right there. Kind of sucks, but that's how it is. Anyhow, I will keep on going. I'm gonna be driving up to Jokkmokk today. Last time I was to Jokkmokk, I did an outside camera view going reverse, camera looking backwards. Not gonna do that today because it's so freaking cold and I don't want my camera, I don't want to risk that my camera is not running properly. It should be able to take this cold, maybe. I don't know the guaranteed temperatures it can hold. I don't know it right now or straight off, but I'm not gonna take any risks. I'm not gonna do that again if it's not getting warmer. Right now it's 23 degrees Celsius, minus Celsius right now outside. Minus 23 degrees Celsius. You know, I have no problem. My beard is freezing as hell. It's pretty much all ice, but I don't care about that. I just don't want to risk that my camera is malfunction. And that the guarantee might not cover it because I have been using it in such a way that it's not covered by the guarantee on it. I need to check that out. If it's supposed to take this cold weather in 80 kilometers an hour, I will try to do some outgoing shoots as well today, maybe. I will see. See you guys later. Finally done here in Jokkmokk. I've been talking to a couple of colleagues about the issue, what the other truck that I actually should have been driving over here today, or everything that I should have been driving with it today. They really don't know what we should do with that truck, because even if we managed to melt the ice plug that is in the air system, air pressure system on the truck, which is the problem. That is the problem with it. That it is an ice plug somewhere. Even if we manage to melt it, it's still gonna be moister, or even just, you know, even a lot of water in the air pressure system. And sooner or later, in this kind of weather condition right now, when it's 25 minus degrees Celsius, it's gonna freeze. It doesn't matter what we do. Basically, what we need to do is we need to melt it, we need to defrost it, and we need to we need to open up the system and drain out the water from the system. And of course we need to check so that the dry air system is working as it's supposed to, so it doesn't take in any more moisture to the air system. But first of all, we need to melt it, defrost it, and then we need to get rid of the water somehow. But question is just how? How do we do that? Anyhow, it's a beautiful day. It's cold as hell, but it is still a beautiful day, I must say. So please enjoy of the scenery. Might not be that much after all. Finally have my second load, which is going to Gammelstad, which is right outside of the town, this town that is, and after that I'm going to the next town, Boden, and I'm gonna be delivering to the gas station over there as well. A little bit of fuel. Snow, actually not that big amount of fuel, but I am fully loaded. I'm kind of close to the maximum amount of weight on the truck and on the trailer, so this can be good. We'll see how this will end. I'm starting to get a little bit tired, but what do you do? Tomorrow I am gonna be driving as well, and I'm gonna be working on Tuesday as well, day before New Year's Eve. And I'm gonna be driving the night shift both of these days, both tomorrow and on Tuesday, because it's a two-day shift, or a two-shift day, I mean. My English no good, no good. Yeah, it's gonna be dark, pretty much as it is right now. It's gonna be for the next 2 days only. Nothing driving during daylight time. Gonna suck, but it's money. I love my money in my pocket. If I could ever earn some decent cash, so I could actually do something except paying bills and getting food, or whatever food I can get, at least. Anyhow, see you later down the road. So there you have it, my day is done, and it's gonna be tight. That is because that stupid truck that I was supposed to be driving this day, today, because it was frozen so much, so it couldn't even load up. I hate when shit like that happens. It sucks. Because really, you are powerless. You can do shit about it. Except just hope that whatever you're doing is solving it. Especially in a system like we have on these trucks. Oh, holy crap. What the hell is behind me now? Is it a private car? Is it a car? Or what is going on? Can't see. Looks like a police car. Almost. It's driving really, really close. Like that. Stay off. No, that is a private. Might be a taxi. For some reason, sometimes taxi cars here in town, at least, for some reason, they look like a little bit older civilian cop cars, or you know, just regular older cop cars, painted ones. Oh, okay. Was a worker at the heating plant we just passed. Well, anyhow, if you have been watching this video so this far and you have been looking through the whole video, you're awesome. I know, at least I am not. No, seriously, thank you for watching this far till the end. If you're a subscriber as well, a member of my family here, or a little community, awesome. If not, please rethink your choice if you wanna join, or if you don't gonna. Would be glad if you would join us if you haven't already. Oh yeah, remember to rate as well. In other words, go scroll down a little bit and give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you didn't like or dislike the video. And most importantly, leave a comment about your thoughts about the video, or just say hi or whatever. I have gotten a couple of questions I will answer through a video, but I will answer them most likely tomorrow, because I'm gonna be needing to read them so I fully understand what the question is about, or the questions, not just one. We'll see. Now, thank you for stopping by, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!